Let me paint you a little picture here. In this picture, Kate is sitting at her desk and she's wrestling with an ethical choice. Kate runs a cornflake manufacturing plant employing 5 workers: Bill, Jill, Gil, Hill, and Phil. These folks are happy to be working here. They do find the job kind of boring, and occasionally there are workplace accidents. For instance, last week, Bill almost lost a finger to the corn crumbler. But they're not complaining. A job's a job, and they make rent. But recently, Kate learned about a new automated cornflake maker. This thing requires only one specialized operator, plus a yearly maintenance fee. But this thing can pump out cornflakes at 3 times the speed, and only half the cost. Kate knows she can keep on Phil and have him trained, but what's she going to do about the others? Buying the cornflake maker, it's better for Kate, it's better for her business, I'm going to argue it's better for society, but can she lay off her employees? Is that ethical? Well, Kate, automation leads to higher productivity and lower production costs. This means the price of your cornflakes can drop from $5 to $1 per box, while still maintaining the same profit margin. And now, you're undercutting your competitors, making even more profit. But Kate, this choice isn't about you now. You have to think of parents like Larry and Mary, who are sinking $5 a week into cornflakes to keep up with their son, little Jerry's ravenous morning appetite. By saving that $4 a week, they're going to have an extra $200 per year of disposable income. This new disposable income creates opportunities for Larry and Mary to spend money on new things. With that extra cash, they can go to the movies, they could get a massage. Hell, they could even buy another box of handmade organic free-range cornflakes. And this isn't just true of Larry and Mary, but of people everywhere. So now that people are spending money on different stuff, it's going to create new demand for different jobs. Maybe Bill always wanted to be a masseuse and he was just a cornflaker out of necessity. Well, now there's opportunities for him to be hired in that field. He's not going to have to be worried about losing a finger to the corn crumbler. And maybe all these people going to the movies means that the popcorn industry is going to explode. Well, Gil's already an expert in corn, so the popcorn industries are going to be fighting to get that expertise on their side. And hey, maybe Hill loves cornflake making for the artistry of it. Now she can take that trade and sell handmade cornflakes to the market of connoisseurs dissatisfied with the impersonal machine-made cornflakes. And Jill, she was the hardest for Kate to let go. Jill still keeps Kate up at night, but now that Kate's making more profit, she can hire Jill back as a researcher to keep Kate's company ahead of the competition. Jill can experiment with different formulas and processes, finding new ways to increase the shelf life and the flavor of her cornflakes, giving consumers better cornflakes than ever before. So the point is, when processes are automated, you get cheaper goods and better goods, which increases everyone's living standards. And you're not destroying jobs, you're just shifting them around and opening up jobs in new and different fields. Maybe jobs people feel passionate about, like safer jobs and easier jobs. So Kate, it's awkward, and let's be honest, when somebody's laid off, they're not going to take comfort in the knowledge of the greater economic trends and factors. But if your question is it ethical, and should you do it? The answer is yes. Because that's how societies develop, and it's why the people around us complain about poor Wi-Fi rather than starvation. So do it, Kate, and in the long run, we'll all be better off.